add to the Ozark atmosphere in here, and it makes it a good distraction for our tours. So when you're finished looking there, you can go ahead and follow me to the second room.
Look at that guy in there, cooking the shine. Cooking the shine in there. I want some.
It's in my bag.
And then step into the center of the room and square dance on a 10x10 wooden platform instead of a foot tall. We no longer have square dances in here though. Instead we have a gospel singing group called the Lesters that perform here twice a year. Once on Easter Sunday weekend, again in late October for our fall festival. Now go ahead and take a look around you. This rock that's all around us is called dolomite. Even though it looks kind of spongy, it's actually very dense and non-porous. The water can't seep down through the ground and into the cave. That's why we don't have any formations forming in this room. But don't worry, we will see many formations later on during the tour. So before we go any further, I actually have three rules for everybody. The first rule is no eating, drinking, or smoking while on tour. The second rule is to stay caught up with the group and stay behind me at all times because I do turn on and off about 300 different light switches. Keyword off, I don't want to lose anybody in the dark today. And then the third and most important rule is to not touch any part of the cave, like the ceilings, the walls, and especially the cave formations. That's because our skin produces a natural oil that stunts the growth of the cave if we touch it. That being said, you can go ahead and follow me to the next room.
How long have you been doing this?
A couple of years.
How big it is.
Right. That's where the electrical system is. They actually set this up.
Yeah.
Just imagine that. You run lights
right
here.
Look at all this.
Look at that.
Oh my God.
Jumped out of here.
For 24 hours. However, ours does not quite work that way because it was built by a group of high schoolers. The reason that it doesn't work that way is because the hinge at the ceiling is made out of iron ore. It rusted shut so the ball can't turn and rotate. It was actually supposed to weigh 1,000 pounds. They did their calculations wrong and only weighs 98. So unfortunately, our ball here only swings for about an hour and a half and then it just stops. So, even though it's kind of pointless, we still show it anyways because it is the only one that's been built inside of a cave. So when you're finished,
the idea that matters.
Look at that thing up there.
Only it worked.
I mean, yep.
Got up there.
Give the high school credit. Yeah.
Do a Miley Cyrus off of that thing.
I'm gonna go jump out on the thing.
Okay, from a rope.
I might be better than I'm not going to try to
Division. We call it division because it's the room that divides the lower half of the cave from the upper half of the cave. Here to take the tour in the 1930s. This is actually where the tours used to stop. And I know that sounds kind of awful, but back then tours only cost a nickel, and then you would just turn around and party in the ballroom. So it couldn't have been too bad.
Well,
the reason that the tours used to stop here is because this wall of dolomite used to extend all the way down past these modern-day handrails, and then a pool of water would spill up into the room about halfway here. For the upper division, this entire hole in the wall was covered with dolomite, except for an 8-inch crack in the upper right-hand corner. Lester B. Dill, the first owner of the cave, discovered that 8-inch crack back in 1933, and he decided to climb the wall. He yelled through the crack, received a powerful echo back, and then just kind of assumed there'd be more caverns to be discovered. He blew out the wall, discovered the 5th, 6th, and 7th levels of the cave, started giving tours up there later that year. In 1941, Missouri suffered a severe drought, so that water level that was halfway into the room, it dropped down about 30 feet past those doors. And a cool breeze rolled out from underneath the dolomite wall. Lester Dill, assuming that there was more caverns to be discovered, he decided to be very brave and courageous one day and sent two tour guides back there swimming in that nice warm 45-degree water. They did come up on a dry piece of land. It's an anvil-shaped rock. They found 26 rusted artifacts scattered around the rock. They date back to 1874. So as soon as I turn my lights off behind us, we can head down.
So are you sure on the dates?
Yes. Going down.
Because I thought it was 35 that they found them up there.
Just 26.
I'm messing with you, I'm sorry.
She knows her stuff.
Yeah, she does.
She
says it 6 times a day.
You should have came back, you know, done your research before you came here.
Right?
Yeah,
I would
have called you up in all time.
Yeah.
But you say it 6 times a day.